So I thought we would practice a little chipping using the hairspray technique just to get you up to speed with what's been done to this hull already. I have applied some Zimmerit to the front and also down both sides of the hull. Once that was completed, the entire model was primed using Tamiya's gray surface primer. Once that was dry, the base coat I used was Model Master Enamel Chocoladen Brown or Chocolate Brown. The reason why I went with that color was in case I decided to use Tamiya's XF64 Red Brown as part of the three-tone camouflage paint scheme. You can see that the chocolate brown contrasts very well with the red brown, which will make it easier to see. The entire model was then coated in Tester's gloss coat lacquer. For the hairspray, we'll be using some Suave Max Hold. It's just something I grabbed off the shelf. I don't think it's anything special. And to capture the hairspray, I have this glass jar, which I will then dump into the airbrush, as that is what I will be using to apply the hairspray to the model. I think it's just a little more controlled application. So with that, I think we will load up the airbrush and get started. So as the hairspray coat dries, I'm going to mix up my camo base coat with 15 drops of Tamiya XF60 Dark Yellow. To that, I'm going to add 5 more drops of XF4 Yellow Green for a total of 20 drops of paint. I'm going to thin that with 30 drops of lacquer thinner. Okay, I think we've allowed sufficient time for the hairspray to dry. It's at least dry to the touch. So we're going to go ahead and start putting on our base coat. Okay, the base coat is on, and I'm going to mix up some dark green next. So next, we're going to apply some dark green, and start our camouflage pattern. So here we go.
Thank you.
And next up is some red brown. Okay, I think that probably should work for our demonstration, so we'll call that quits and start the chipping. Okay, I think we're ready to start chipping, and I'm going to start out by using this little bit softer brush because I'm not quite sure how this is going to work out. I'd rather start soft and go to a little bit more stiff brush. If it needs to be that way. I'm going to try to keep the model in the center of the screen, but at times I might need to take a little bit better look at it. So with that, we're going to start applying a little bit of the warm water around various raised surfaces and see if we can't start getting that hairspray layer to start softening up. Okay. Oh, yeah, it's already starting there a little bit. I don't know if you can see that little spot right there at the end of the brush, but that started to come off already. Oh, yeah. So I think it's better to kind of start small and see what you get here. And I'm going to kind of try to start out a less is more, and then we'll see what happens as we go on with the demonstration. Okay, I'm gonna see if I can show you a little bit on that radio antenna there. A lot of the edges, the top portion here is starting to get chipped. So maybe we'll leave that for now. I want to work a little bit more on this area here. Oh yeah, it's a... I don't know if you can see that there, it kind of started taking it off the edges, all the high surfaces. I think most of these raised areas, you know, would be the areas that would be chipped the most, either from foot scuffing or debris falling down on the tank, if it was especially if it was like fighting in a city or something and had a bunch of bricks fall on it or something like that. It's kind of getting a little frothy in here. Makes it kind of hard to see. Okay, I think we'll try, let's try a little bit over here now. Give that a chance to kind of start working a little bit. And I tried to purposely spray, like this area here has got a little bit more dark brown on it. This area here has got a little more of the dark green, and we got a lot of dark yellow over here. That way we can kind of see, you know, how the different, how the chipping's going to look over the different colors. There, it's starting to work. See, I'm trying to concentrate on that edge right there a little bit. That's actually looking kind of good. You know, and then, then you can just take a big hunk out of it just like that too. So, you know, you just kind of gotta... gotta go easy at it, I guess. There's a big old hunk that just came off right there. And another one right there. So yeah, you really gotta go... You know, if you don't want a whole lot of chipping effect, you got to go easy and just kind of work a small area at a time. But I still don't think that looks too awful bad. But so let's play around with this one here now, and maybe we'll try to be a little more careful. There, it's starting to take effect a little bit right around in here. Oh yeah, boy, you just got to barely touch that and just kind of move the brush a little bit and it knocks it right off. Okay, let's mess around with these hinges just a little bit. We'll get those soaking, and maybe we'll do a little bit on these here, get these loosened up. I think for the heck of it, we'll try this brush here. This is the smallest of the round brushes that I kind of showed you a little bit before, and we'll just kind of lightly go at it, see what happens. Oh yeah, that's coming off pretty darn easy with this stiffer brush here. Almost too easy. Okay, I think I'm going to go back to the softer brush again, and we'll just try to get a little bit off these edges here. That's starting to work already. Boy, that comes off pretty easily. See, it kind of took a big hunk off right there. Okay, I've got my toothpick here, and it's kind of hard to get in on this edge with the brush, so let's just try teasing a little bit of that paint off the outer, this rim right here. Oh yeah, that chips off pretty darn easy, just like that. Let's maybe put a little, we can try to put a little scratch or something across here, maybe. Tease a little bit of that. Boy, look how that just comes right off. Yeah. So, I think if you're doing this on your actual model, boy, you'd really want to take your time, because it can come off in a hurry. I'm going to try a little bit, like, around this edge here, since that would be kind of hard to get to with a brush, and it looks like it's coming off really easily with the toothpick here. So maybe since we have that started just a little bit, I'm gonna try to feather it with this paintbrush here. Oh yeah, that looks pretty good. So I kind of like that. I think maybe this toothpick would probably come in better even for here too, so you can just lightly touch, you know, some of these edges here, instead of knocking off a bunch, you know, in the middle, you can kind of hit these edges and stuff like that. Maybe we'll try using the toothpick on this one here. So I'm gonna get that kind of soaking just a little bit. Some good warm water loosens that right up. Okay, and we're going to try the toothpick now, and just going to try to scrape these edges here, and it is coming off already. Okay, I'm going to kind of flip that around and try to do the top sides of these now. Okay. And maybe I'll just try to lightly bounce it off this high stuff here. Jeez, it's almost like you're coloring with a brown magic marker the way that comes off. Okay. So that was lightly with the toothpick there, and let's just lightly go after this with the brush a little bit. It seems like once you break an edge open, that water really seeps into that cut and starts loosening up the hairspray around it. So you could make a small scratch into a big scratch in a hurry, I'm thinking. So maybe we'll leave that one alone and take a look at what it looks like after it dries off a little bit. I wanted to work on these periscope protectors there. You got some good sharp edges on these, and I think the hairspray and chipping would look pretty good on those. So we'll start on this one here, just try to hit these sharp edges a little bit. Sorry about that. Okay, I'm gonna try to tease a little bit off with the toothpick there, and that's seems to really be doing the trick. Gotta turn you around a little bit to try to get this top edge here. Probably the angle isn't the greatest, but let's see what we can do here. Okay. Might move this up just a little bit. See if that'll help us. Okay. Oh yeah. Okay, I'm going to try to soften those a little bit with the brush. As you can see, quite a bit just came off right there on that one, but that's okay. Okay. And now, like, say there was, like, major foot traffic or, you know, you wanted to show the top surfaces were maybe a little more worn or scuffed or chipped, whatever. So let's just try to do a little bit on this flat surface here. Get this good and saturated. And boy, do I dare go after it with one of them stiff brushes. Yeah, why not? I'll try the medium round one here that I got and just try to see if we can either tap it or... Ooh, yeah. Yeah, it's starting to... Boy, look at that. Go easy with this brush. There, it's starting to come through the brown layer. Yeah, it doesn't take much effort at all to start getting, for it to start eating through. Yeah, you can see a big hunk just came off right there in the green. So that's kind of an interesting effect. Let's rough up this engine deck just a little bit more. I think I'll use my soft brush to saturate that surface. Okay. And we'll just start kind of agitating the surface here a little bit and see if we can get that to come off. I'm just kind of doing circular motions very lightly. Now we're just getting crazy with it. But I think that pretty much demonstrates what we were trying to do anyways. Yeah, that's coming off of there with almost zero effort. So it would be good to know ahead of time, you know, are you looking for light chipping? Are you looking for heavy? Where was the vehicle fighting? You know, that could have a kind of a big influence. Like I say, if this was more like urban combat, you know, you'd have a lot of bricks and lamp posts and falling on it and really tearing it up. Could be the vehicle could just have seen some really serious heavy usage too, and just be you know, if it's a later in the war model or diorama that you're doing, you know, it might have quite a bit more weathering and scuffing and stuff like that, chipping too. Well, you could probably spend quite a while just making it look even worse. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing, but I think I'm going to get this thing rinsed off and pat it dry, and we'll kind of take a look and see what we got. And here's a little closer up view of our chipping. As you can see, the chipped areas are very shiny. That's that gloss coat showing through, and I'm sure that the gloss coat definitely promoted the chipping, since paint has a harder time sticking to a shiny smooth surface, which is what we created with that gloss coat. And maybe that's why we got some of the bigger sheets of paint to come off. You'd probably have different results if you used a dull coat versus the clear coat like what we did here. So results may vary. This was a pretty fun video to do, and hopefully it gives somebody some ideas of either what to do or maybe even what not to do. So depending on whatever look you're going for. But this definitely created some very interesting textures and surfaces on the model nonetheless. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and happy modeling.